are tired of destruction and mutual misunderstanding. Only culture, only entire super concept of beauty and knowledge may return to us the language common to all mankind. Peace through culture. It was Russian artist and scholar Nicholas Rerich who was the first to note that the destruction of culture bears mortal threat to the existence of our civilization. It was he who, in the beginning of the previous century, put forward the idea to sign an international pact with an aim to preserve at least the greatest cultural masterpieces in the ravages of war. Since then, mankind has lived through two global war catastrophes. But are the ideas of Nicholas Rerich really out of date now? Grave and quasi-insurmountable hardships burden mankind. Many quasi-irresolvable problems prostrate life and divide peoples, states, families. Even the greatest colossi of civilization are shaken. Truly, the man and mankind are destroyed by ignorance and are restored by hope. The great consolidators of the human race remain culture and beauty. The foundation of universal importance is the Rerich Pact, the international treaty, the first article of which says, educational, artistic and scientific institutions shall be considered as neutral and as such respected and protected by belligerents. To preserve cultural relics in time of military activity, to mark the first step towards the universal peace. It was here, in Brugge, in 1931, that this great idea was articulated for the first time. The first international conference in support of the Rerich Pact was opened in Brugge on September 13, 1931. The artist sends the conference the gift of almost two dozens of his canvases and his warm greeting. He says, "It is not accidentally that the conference is held in Brugge. The very essence of your town is praying for culture." Here, in this hotel in St. Jacob Street, the town authorities accommodated representatives of governments from more than 20 states and delegates of numerous scientific and cultural societies, altogether more than 100 people. The same way as the modern tourists, they looked with curiosity and respect at Brugge walls, covered with hoary antiquity. "Famous are the bells of Brugge," writes Rerich in his greeting to delegates. "Let these bells be the bells of victory of the Banner of Peace Conference." Under the tolling of these bells, the delegates gathered in the town hall, the most ancient in Flanders. Here, the vast hall of the first floor houses the exhibition of photographs of greatest masterpieces and Nicholas Rerich's pictures. On the second floor, under the 14th century vaults, in a luxurious Gothic hall, decorated by finest carving and marvelous wall paintings, the participants of the conference approved the articles of the Rerich Pact, paving the way to protection of culture. We will hear about International Day of Culture, when all schools at one time will devote a day to perception of national and world cultural treasures. We will discuss what particular cultural monuments and collections of cultural values will be under protection of the Banner of Peace. The whole range of issues on beauty and knowledge will be addressed. This was the first international conference of such level for the whole thousand-year-long history of Brugge. It resulted in establishment of the International Foundation and Committee of the Rerich Pact. In August 1932, Brügge saw the second conference in support of the Rurik Pact. It appealed to all countries to recognize the pact as the official act of international law. This conference first voiced the offer to proclaim such European cities as Rome, Venice, Brügge, the museum cities, inviolable in case of military actions. If the task of the Red Cross is to care about the physically injured and the sick, our pact is aimed at guarding values of man's genius, thus keeping spiritual soundness. What is the most important in both cases is preventing a disaster. In spring of 1935, Washington DC housed the 4th International Conference on Protection of Artistic and Scientific Institutions and Historic Monuments. On the 15th of April, at the ceremony held in the White House, the final document was signed by plenipotentiaries of 21 nations of the Americas. In his message, President Roosevelt said, "Given rigid observation of the pact by peoples of the world, we see the way to large-scale implementation of one of the fundamental principles, that is, saving the modern civilization."